It is live television. We're having all kinds of fun doing things live here at Build 2019 at the Washington Convention Center. I've got Ralph Squillace. How are you, sir?
I am doing well. The voice is barely there, but it's still there.
Well, but you got a beautiful head of hair, so you got that going for you.
I feel good.
Yeah, fantastic. So you do all kinds of great things in the cloud with AKS, with the Azure Kubernetes Service.
Sure.
What does Kubernetes mean? No one ever asks that question.
So Kubernetes is actually ancient Greek for, it's typically pilot or captain. But it is also the word, the root stem for governor, believe it or not. So it's metaphorically the leader or the guider. Typically in maritime things.
Okay, so I'm always hearing these maritime or these nautical terms, and I hear about things like Helm. This is all part of the Kubernetes, the ship narrative.
It's the theme. So Helm is what we're going to talk about a little bit today really quickly. It's the default package manager for most of the Kubernetes workloads. So it's one of those tools that if you're already using, you want to know about Helm 3. And if you're not using it yet, or maybe you're in Windows and Windows containers are coming to Kubernetes with 1.14, then maybe you want to learn about Helm a little bit more because it's going to be your operations tool.
There was an interesting keyword there, though. You said the default. The default, does that mean that someone decided that Helm is the default?
No. It's a community open source ecosystem. So there are lots of tools that you can use to do your operations or deployment and management. It just turns out that Helm started very early as a way of compressing and making more efficient the packages, the distributed configuration for a large set of microservices, so that you can just deploy them with a one-line install instead of having to deploy a number of things and manually use a CLI to do your operations work. But there's an extra bonus, and that is Helm also allows you to share your described charts. They're called charts, another nautical theme. Charts have repositories, and so like Docker Hub or GitHub, you can actually share your repositories publicly or privately for corporate use or government use or any private environment.
Okay, so when I have a chart and I've got it ready, do I have a dev test and a production chart, or do I have a chart that has different angles or different dimensions?
As with good software tools, the answer is absolutely. That's kind of unfortunate. Everybody wants, like, this is the way to work it. You can create charts where you flick an operational string. You can set a custom flag when you deploy into a developer environment, and it uses certain configurations that are templated in through your chart that will result in that. Other people choose to keep the charts completely separate so that they can do operational work in different environments and different pipelines without having to deal with the production chart, for example, which might have a lot more specific configuration to it. So it's really flexible and works both ways.
And then if I have decided that Helm is the way I'm doing things at my company, and I've been doing a lot of work on-prem, mm-hmm. and I move over to AKS, I'm going to find AKS to be very comfortable because I already know how to use Helm?
Yes, because it's Kubernetes native operations tool. So anywhere you have a Kubernetes cluster works. So if you're a developer, you can use Helm and Kubernetes on your laptop with Minikube or Docker for Windows or whatever it might be. There's Windows binaries, for example, for Helm, as well as Linux binaries and Mac binaries. So you can use it from any operating system. And you can use it against Windows containers in your cluster or Linux containers in your cluster. It's extremely flexible. So anywhere there's Kubernetes, there's Helm.
That's pretty exciting because I've actually been working on my Windows machine, and I found out that I can go into Docker for Windows and just click a checkbox that says enable Kubernetes, fired up a little server here.
Yes.
I've got a Raspberry Pi cluster, which is a little stack of Kubernetes.
Ooh,
envy. I've got like 6 Pis in a stack.
Envy.
It's very nice. But it's the same one. It's the same experience. It's the same dashboard. It's the same great experience. And then when I moved to AKS, because I had done that work locally, it felt very comfortable.
It should. And that's the way that the community works when they come to a consensus about tooling or about the distributed container kernel, which turns out to be the default choice is Kubernetes. That means you can not only do your own work comfortably from place to place, but also your colleagues, and the way that the knowledge base that we draw from in the future going forward is going to have more and more of that default knowledge no matter where you are, whether you're running in Windows with Windows containers or some other.
When you said consensus, that idea of consensus is really interesting because it's the community deciding, but then Microsoft still is running a service. So how do you balance that?
That is a great question. And the AKS service is fascinating, especially in the history of Azure, because the original service code, Kubernetes, the source code base, is upstream. We don't create it. We contribute to it. Mm. And then we make sure that the implementation that runs in the service is the best that it can possibly be, and makes use of the other Azure services that make your experience as any other service in Azure rich, important, efficient, and cost-effective. So you don't necessarily need to do everything in Kubernetes. Frequently, that won't be the case. For example, Cosmos DB gives you features that a Kubernetes cluster cannot do. Mm. But you might want to use do execution in Kubernetes and AKS, have us manage the cluster for you. You only deal with the applications, and one of your databases might be a service in Cosmos DB.
You know, it's really interesting, the idea that you said it's upstream, and this is important because the world of open source, as well as the world of running a service that makes money in a business and a giant company, it's a business of co-opetition. Because we have other people that are running Kubernetes services, and they want to make theirs the best they can, and then we all basically, to use a nautical term, like, you know, the water level rises all boats.
That's right. Upstream really is upstream. It is, that's where the source comes from, and in that metaphor, everybody can participate. The network effect of growing skill sets, the collection of charts for Helm, for example, or Kubernetes manifest that have already been written, they actually add value to everybody. And then the special value that a cloud provider like Microsoft can bring gives it even more special sauce for you, or if you're a customer of Microsoft or of Azure specifically.
Now, I don't know if I asked you this before, but maybe I can put you on the spot. We've got about 3 minutes remaining. Can you Helm something?
Yeah, let's Helm something.
In 3 minutes? You got like 3 minutes to Helm.
Can you
something.
See the magic screen?
Let's go ahead and bring up your screen and see how quickly you can cause some trouble. Are you outputting?
Ah, we got the mirror. Let's do the mirror.
Oh, you're on another screen.
Yeah, we got another screen. So this is helm.sh.
All right.
Right? And that's where you go to learn about Helm, but it's rendering a little large. We'll just go drop it down real quickly.
There you go.
But the thing about Helm is this is where you'd go to start your journey if you didn't know about it. But if you click the charts, what you go to is Helm Hub, and we'll drop it down again. And Helm Hub is any number of community charts for almost all of the applications that you may have heard about. For example, here's Cassandra.
Right.
Right? So if we go over to a terminal, which I will also move over there.
Yeah, if we could actually put something up in 2 minutes, that'd be amazing.
That would be
that'd
great.
Be like the demo
so
of
we got
conference.
Big, big modes. And you're looking at a cluster over here, and it's not scaled correctly, but we'll work with it because we got 2 minutes. So Helm, instead of actually knowing what I want to install, I can actually search for it. So I can do Helm search Mongo.
Oh, look
right?
at that.
And MongoDB. And we can go, and we'll find at the stable repository any number of charts. If I want to install one, I don't actually have to know how to install Mongo. I just want to use it,
right.
Especially as a developer, right? So I would just do Helm.
It's just like apt-get for the cloud.
It is apt-get for the cloud.
You've got 90
Helm,
seconds.
Install.
I'm going to be amazed.
Let's do name. Do we got autocomplete?
You can hit tab.
You know what?
You
I'm going to do WordPress instead,
WordPress.
Just to be a rebel.
Tab your way to glory.
WordPress being the, now if we're scaled out a little bit here, but we're pointing at a mixed cluster of Windows nodes and Linux nodes. You can see we immediately get
log in with the
multiple services here.
Okay.
We get multiple pods. A pod is a logical word for a set of containers. Typically one, but it can have more.
45 seconds. What URL is this at? Can we
what
go there?
URL? We may not make it. So it is pending.
Oh, it's pending. Okay, so you fired that up. You've put that into Kubernetes. It's in there now in the cluster IP, but it has to go and allocate an external
That's
IP.
That's right. And because this is AKS, this is one of those combinations between the upstream implementation and Azure. It's getting an Azure external LB right now, and which has to allocate the IP. Sometimes that takes 30 seconds, which means we might fall just off the edge.
In the next 8 seconds, I'm going to tell you that you're awesome and that we're going to have you on the show again to talk all about AKS. And you can learn about Helm and AKS on other episodes of Azure Friday.
Oh, can we do Windows too?
We'll do all kinds of things and Windows.
Deal.
It's Azure Friday Live. That's live television, people.